Hello friend, welcome to Accurate YouTube Learning Channel, Accurate ASME ISO. In this video, let us understand about the measurement of perpendicularity when there is a perpendicularity chord of a large surface with a very short cylinder. Short cylinder as a datum. The most challenges in this measurement is inconsistency or non-repeatability of the measurement. So let us understand what are the challenges in the measurement and what are the solutions probable. So hope you would like this video. Please do not forget to like it and forward with your friends. Thank you. Let us begin now. On the three coordinate measuring machine, a part what you see here of very large diameter and a plane on top having a small cylinder length but at the larger diameter. The measurement is going on by measurement plane with few number of points and the measurement of cylinder. The cylinder being a very large diameter and very short length, the two sections are measured at bottom and at the upper level. While measurement is being done on the machine, parallelly we can see the measurement is carried out the software display. In the graphics we can easily see the number of points being measured on the plane as well as on the cylinder at two levels. After the measurement, the perpendicularity is calculated. First, the perpendicularity of a cylinder with respect to datum plane, and the second perpendicularity by changing, or we say reversing, the features. It is an inspection report output of the part measured. Here two results we have taken. The first one is measurement of a plane as a perpendicularity with respect to datum A, and the another measurement is the perpendicularity of a short cylinder and with respect to a larger plane datum B. Here it is clearly observed when there is a very short cylinder datum is taken and perpendicularity of the larger surface is measured. So results are 0.139, whereas when plane is taken as a datum and measured of a short cylinder, the value only gives 14 microns. So in the slides ahead coming, we are going to discuss the causes why these values are changing and what are the probable the solutions for this kind of the measurement. Let us understand first, according to the international standard ISO and ASME, what is the perpendicularity? Let us define perpendicularity of a cylinder axis related to datum plane. The extracted median line or the axis of the cylinder shall within a cylindrical tolerance zone of specified diameter. So here 0.01 is a specified tolerance zone and the shape of the tolerance zone is cylindrical, and it must be perpendicular to datum plane. Perpendicularity of a plane with respect to datum axis. The definition is the extracted points on the plane or the plane of the surface shall be within two parallel tolerance zones of specified tolerance. The specified tolerance is here 0.08, and two parallel tolerance plane are these two planes. So these two parallel planes must be perpendicular to the datum axis. Now let us understand how the perpendicularity is calculated. This is seen for first perpendicularity of cylinder with respect to datum plane A. So here is the plane which is a nominal datum plane as given in the drawing, and here is a short cylinder axis. It is treated as tolerance cylinder axis. So how the perpendicularity is calculated between these two, let us see in next slide. For the simplification purpose only, let us take plane as this as a line and short cylinder here as also a line. So the angle between the plane and the short cylinder axis is 90 degree here as a nominal. When we do the measurement, so it is a actual axis which is a small deviated with some angle. This is a actual datum plane, measured plane is called D, and here is a actual measured cylinder. Now the angle between actual datum plane and tolerance cylinder axis is theta. The actual measurement between these two, the angle theta is 89 degrees and 57 minutes. And this is a height h of that short cylinder. This is actual measured value is 16 millimeter. Now what is the perpendicularity? Perpendicularity is the P. How a perpendicularity is calculated? It is simple with the calculation of trigonometry. So this is a value called perpendicularity. This is h and this theta is nothing but 90 degrees minus 89 degree 57 minutes. So using the trigonometry formula, P is equal to tan of 90 degrees minus 89 degrees 57 minutes into the height h. So h we know it is a 16 millimeter, and when the calculation is completed, the perpendicularity of a cylinder axis with respect to given datum plane D is the 14 microns. Now let us take the another condition by changing a datum. Now the datum is cylinder axis and tolerance element is a plane. So what is the difference here? The angle between the plane and the cylinder remains constant, but the datum length is very short compared to the plane length. Now height h is also the same. How perpendicularity value is calculated? We know that all the points or all the elements on the actual plane should lie within two parallel planes, and these two parallel planes must be perpendicular to the datum feature called as a datum cylinder axis. So this value is a perpendicularity. So this value here we say it is a P, and here is the angle 90 minus theta, and this P value is again calculated with respect to the Pythagoras theorem. So here is how the calculation goes. The angle never changes. It is 89 degree 57 minutes. Height measured, as already we know, of a cylinder 16 millimeter. Now here is one calculation with respect to datum. The perpendicularity of a plane is calculated, and the length of the plane is 160 millimeter. So the calculation of the P comes, P is equal to tan of 90 degrees minus 89 degree 57 minutes and into the D. So in this case it is happening like this, okay. So P is equal to again tan 90 degrees minus 89 degree 57 minutes. Now in this case the length 160 is input. After doing the calculations, the value comes 139 microns. So in the first case, when there was a perpendicularity of a plane, it was 14 micron. Now when it is with respect to a short cylinder, it is 113 micron. In both the cases, the angle theta remains constant, but the datum is changed, reversed, the calculation in the mathematics get changed. So this is a tolerance zone which is calculated as perpendicularity of a plane with respect to short cylinder. Interpreting the results. The perpendicularity of the plane with respect to short datum cylinder axis is 139 micron and perpendicularity of a short cylinder of height 16 millimeter with a larger plane is only 14 micron. So how we should interpret the things? So here we can say that at the constant angle between the plane and the cylinder, perpendicularity changes with respect to datum change because of the length or size of the tolerance feature. Most of the time it is misinterpreted that this happened because of the CMM accuracy, and we have seen here the angle once it is measured between the two remains constant. Here it is the constant angle, but when we change the datum for the perpendicularity, then the values are getting changed. To justify that the accuracy doesn't matter a lot, we have carried the same experiment with a contour tracer, one of the highest accuracy instrument, and also on the master artifact ring gauge. So uncertainty of the form tolerances of the component is eliminated. Here we have used the contour tracer of accuracy guideways less than 1 micron over 120 millimeter range, and the resolution of the measurement is only 0.04 micron. So doing the experiment with the highest accuracy equipment and so as to on the master ring gauge, tracing this and calculating the same as we have done the experiment in three coordinate measuring machine, we can build our confidence that the accuracy of the equipment is not mattered when we interchange the datums, and that interchangeability variation is because of the geometric dimensioning and tolerancing concept. Here is the measurement taken from the contour tracer. So yellow lines shown here on the LH side and RH side on the surface of the ring gauge. So here is one line and here is another. Making this as a one common line and the vertical line traced on the cylinder, the angle is 90 degrees 1 minute and 18 seconds. And therefore, when we calculate it from the 90 degree as a deviation, it comes as 0 degree 1 minute and 18 second. So angle between the plane and the vertical line never changed, it would remain constant. And with taking this information, in the next slide we do the calculation of perpendicularity. The perpendicularity for this vertical line and perpendicularity for this horizontal line. It is perpendicularity calculation for cylinder line with respect to datum line on the plane. The contour tracer measured angle between the two lines 0 degree 1 minute and 18 seconds. It is the angle deviated from the 90 degrees. Let us now calculate the perpendicularity P1 of the vertical cylindrical line. So here theta is 0 degree 1 minute and 18 second. The height measured is 10 millimeter and the D, the length of the plane, is 85 millimeter. So P1 is equal to tan of the angle deviation into the height. And if we put the value of height 10, then the value P1, that is the perpendicularity of the vertical line, that is the so called axis of the cylinder, is 0.0038 millimeter, that is 3.8 micrometer. Now let us see the perpendicularity calculation of surface line with respect to cylinder line. Here cylinder line is short as 10 millimeter, whereas the surface line on the plane measured as 85 millimeter. We know again angle between both the elements remain same as deviation observed 0 degree 1 minute and 18 seconds. Therefore perpendicularity of plane with respect to cylinder P2 is equal to tan of 0 degree 1 minute 18 second into the total length of that line, that is 85 millimeter, and the total value of the perpendicularity comes as 32 micrometers. The same ring gauge is measured on three coordinate measuring machine, and the same way changing the datum the perpendicularity is verified. So with respect to the larger size of the complete plane, the axis of that the cylinder of the ring gauge shows the perpendicularity as the same as in case of the contour tracer. It was 3.8 and now it has come 3.9. And when we check the perpendicularity of the complete surface with respect to short cylinder axis of the ring gauge, it is showing 46 microns against 32 microns in case of the contour tracer. So on the same time, in case of the CMM, we have taken the complete surface then the length. And what we can conclude here is that maybe the CMM or the contour tracer, maybe the machine of the 2 micron accuracy or the accuracy of 0.04, which is the highest in the measurement we have taken as an equipment. So it changing the datums for the perpendicularity measurement is not a matter of the equipment, but it is a complete mathematical observations by doing so.
Question: report of the cylinder's perpendicularity to the datum plane are acceptable, however reversing the features significantly alters the findings. Is it a CMM problem? Answer: no. It is not a CMM or measuring machine problem. Question, then, what problem is it? Answer, fundamentally, it is not a problem at all. It is GD&T concept given by International Standard of Calculating the Perpendicularity Tolerance with respect to datum. Question, how to analyze this problem in brief? Answer, if datum length, width, size, area of datum features are not to the geometric perfection, i.e. insufficient in its dimensions compared to the tolerance feature, then such challenges are obvious. Question, any suggestion about the sufficient length or size of the datum? Answer, if datum dimensions are 3 times bigger than tolerance feature, then more appropriate stability is confirmed. Note, in our concentricity measurement video, more details have been discussed on this topic.
Hope that you like this video. Please do not forget to subscribe the channel and share it to others. For training inquiry, please find the contact details on the slide. Thank you, friends. Take care. Bye for this time. See you soon for the next video. Thank you once again.
Hello, I'm Dheeraj from Encircle Tech. We went to G&T training and it was really useful in terms of understanding domains. How exactly G&T is used in the domain. Not just the symbolic meaning of each of the tolerances, but in what applications these tolerances are used. And going ahead, we'll be using this knowledge by developing the application user interface, interacting with our customers, and finally, customer satisfaction. I think this is a very useful training for everyone who is involved in the domain. Thank you.